What's good? It's your boy Cali back with another video. So today we got a Las Vegas landlord forcing women to sign contracts for sex. What kind of creepy ass shit is this? If you enjoy the content, make sure you share and subscribe. Your boy really appreciate it. Let's do this.
Ordered to rent a home as part of an ongoing federal trial now. 13 Chief Investigator Darcy Spears has the bizarre story of a property manager who required his tenant to sign a sex contract and is now facing allegations of discrimination, harassment, and fraud. Darcy, what is this all about?
Well, you guys, it's actually hard to fathom that someone would put something like this in writing. We've had to cover some of the words because we can't show them on TV, but here it is in black and white. It's so crazy, I didn't believe it until I saw it in the court record.
This is Alan Rothstein, the man who wrote the sex contract. Court records show he forced a prospective tenant to sign it in November 2018 in order to rent this four-bedroom home on Wedgebrook Street near Las Vegas Boulevard and St. Rose Parkway. At the time, Rothstein was the property manager and also a real estate broker. He lost both licenses after a Nevada Real Estate Division investigation. He now stands to lose a lot more if a federal judge finds him guilty. He's currently on trial for violations of the Fair Housing Act in this lawsuit filed by his former tenant. And the facts are unlike anything this experienced housing lawyer has ever seen.
My reaction was, you had to be putting me on, that nobody in their right mind would go to the trouble to draw up a contract like this.
No one involved would talk to us as the trial is ongoing. We asked legal expert Bruce Flammy to analyze the case.
Have you ever seen anything like this?
No, not even on bar exams in law school. Nobody has ever put something like this together that I've ever seen. Although, in all candor, I think there's more of these out there.
Sources close to the case tell 13 Investigates this is not the first time Rothstein has done this, and there are other victims. Rothstein himself admitted to the real estate division that he wrote the sex contract and required...
Man, of course this ain't the first time this dude has done this. This is the type of dude that guaranteed to have no play back in high school or any other time in his lifetime. And he tried to take advantage of his situation once he got some money and start trying to trick women who are, you know, struggling in life and need help, and trying to force them to have sex with him. That's some creepy ass shit.
Whatever ransom you're asking for, they'll pay it.
It rubs the lotion on its skin or else it gets the hose again.
Dude is tripping.
Hired the tenant to sign it, and in court records, he says any agreements or documents mentioned speak for themselves.
When somebody says the document speaks for itself, what they're really saying is, I don't want to talk about it.
We're talking about it to the extent that we can. We'll begin with the title.
It's direct consent for sexual intercourse and or which is in italics. Who names a document that?
It goes on to say, please read this legal contract carefully.
And that's where I started laughing, because this is a legal contract the way the actors on Grey's Anatomy are real doctors, okay? This is literally not worth the paper it's printed on.
The terms of the so-called contract are even crazier than the title. The tenant had to swear she wasn't signing under the influence of any...
He basically creates contracts to have women as his sex slave. What kind of shit is that? Freaky shit.
Any intoxicant, including alcohol, drugs, oysters...
Truffles, sea cucumber, strawberries, lobster. I've never known anybody to be under the influence of lobster. Dark chocolate, cocaine, LSD, and cannabis. I don't know where you get a list like that.
Another paragraph says the tenant swears she does not currently have a boyfriend, girlfriend, or parent who is larger, meaner, and more physically aggressive, owns firearms, and or is more possessive than Rothstein.
She was told if she didn't sign this, she was not going to be able to get the unit. So for all intents and purposes, it's exactly sex for a place to live. It's exactly what it is. And it's almost sex on demand.
What do we make of the fact that she initialed this thing?
Nothing. People sign things all the time, and the popular myth is, well, you signed it, so it's binding. Yeah. There are a variety of things you can sign that are not binding. Any contract that is against the law or public policy is not binding.
So why would anyone sign anything like this? Court documents say in August 2018, the tenant and her five children were homeless, living from week to week in a residential hotel. The Southern Nevada Regional Housing Authority threw them a lifeline, approving them for Section 8, a federal program that funds local public housing authorities to help low-income families rent from private landlords.
But one of the provisions of Section 8 is that once you're approved, you have to find a residence that will be covered by the program within about 60 days of when you're approved. Now, depending on where she was in that 60-day window when this thing came up, she may not have had other options.
Court records say she'd been allowed to move in and paid out of pocket to fix up the house so HUD would approve it.
So when you slap this document down in front of her and say, sign this or you have no place to live, that's coercion, that's duress, and I believe it's a violation of federal law.
The tenant's lawsuit alleges several other violations, including charging illegal fees and wrongful eviction after she refused any sexual encounters. In court records, Rothstein disputes any fair housing violations. Attorney Falami says no matter the outcome of the civil trial, accountability shouldn't stop there.
There may or may not have been crimes committed here. The word extortion flashes in my mind in this kind of situation. But that's not what this trial is about that's going on in federal court right now. But this is a good example of a case where maybe somebody ought to go to jail.
We got a woman getting poisoned with fentanyl. If you enjoy the content, make sure you share and subscribe. Your boy, I really appreciate it. Let's do this.
He could see that I'm recording him and tell him that I fucking noticed him. Just in case people thought I was tripping and, you know, just want to record to just show y'all I'm not tripping. Come on, Jewel, hurry up. Not tripping. Like,
that's a mighty full sack you're carrying.
Piss off, you perverted old freak.
Ooh, we got a fighter.
It's so obvious, and he sees what I'm doing, and still is following me. Like,
so wait a minute. You telling me that this dude back here is following you already? He sees you recording him, and he doesn't care. Already red flags.
Bitch. I said, come on. Like, I'm really not tripping. I'm not tripping at fucking all. I'm sweating because I'm nervous, but I'm not tripping.
This is the time where you walk to a public place, McDonald's, Burger King, police station.
Tripping at fucking all. So he does not work here?
No, I've never seen that guy in my life.
Okay. All righty, come over here. We're going to wait on security to walk us to our car, okay? So we're waiting on security to come and walk us to our car because the guy doesn't work here. And yeah, that was some weird ass shit. You security?
Yeah, I am.
You got a gun?
And see, people, this is why you got to be careful out there. And this is why my circle is so small, bro. I keep it real. You can't trust everybody out here. Everybody's not your friend.
I have one in my car, but that's in the car. Come on, Junior. Security's going to walk us to our car. So make sure we're safe. And he's walking directly with security. Security is walking us to our car because people is weird. Oh, we get to my car. Look what's on my fucking door. Like, look what's on my fucking door. So we waiting on NOPD to come out here because they don't know what the fuck. Like, am I right? I wasn't all right earlier. That's why I got offline.
Now, before we keep watching, y'all tell me what you think it is. Let me know in the comments section.
Is I actually overdose. I still look fucked up, but I'm all right. Here's your update. I'll tell y'all everything.
So what? Because the video abruptly ended. So basically, they put the napkins in the door handle and maybe laced it with fentanyl, and then you touched it and rubbed your face or something. I don't know, people. I'll watch what you watch. On to the next video.
Earlier today in the show, there was a gentleman who was in the crowd and he couldn't see. He couldn't see, and motherfuckers were all around him, fucking with him. So we did our best to bring him on stage and give him the best fucking view of the house. All right, look at the crowd, look at the crowd. What is your name?
Hamad.
Oh man, it's a pleasure to meet you. How old are you?
I'm 19.
Yeah, 19. So wait, where were you in the crowd? Where were you sitting?
I was back there.
Hey, fuck y'all over there who was fucking with him. So this is what we're gonna do right now. You gonna fucking kick it up here for the last song. And after this song plays, you get every single piece of merchandise for free tonight. And we gonna turn the motherfucker up. Can I get a hell yeah?
Hell yeah!
Can I get a hell yeah?
Hell yeah!
I work hard every motherfucking day, yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on. I work hard every day, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Make some noise for my man. It was a pleasure to meet you. I love you all.
One more time, if you had a good time, make some noise for Logic.
My name is Hamad, I'm from Dubai. Came all the way just to see Logic and Wiz. I've been a fan for a long time. I can't count, it was such an experience I would never forget. And Logic gave me his hat that I would keep it for my entire life. I never expected to be on stage. Don't give up on your dreams.